Excel from the Excel podcast, episode 1544, Sakai Gradebook, convert percentage score to letter grade. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jell, and all week we've been talking about this gradebook project. And today, episode 1544, we're going to talk about converting percentage scores to letter grade. So let's take a look at where we are right now. We have this percentage score, and we want to convert that to a letter grade. And the way we're going to do that, we're going to count them out to the right somewhere. And you always start the table like this. You say, if you get a 0, you're going to get an F. All right. And then the next thing you have to ask yourself is, which score will get me some other grade? All right. So in your grading scale, is it 60%? Is it 65%? Let's say it's 65. I want to put 0.65. You'll get a D. And then at 0.7, you'll get a C. 0.8, you'll get a B. And 0.9, you'll get an A. And maybe you have more grades than this. Maybe you have D minus and D plus and so on. The important point is that you create your table going from smallest to largest. So always start at 0 and work your way up. And then Excel is smart enough that, let's say that someone has a 0.78, it's going to look for 0.78, it's not going to find it. And so it's going to give us a value just smaller, which is 0.7, which is the C. And to make my life a little bit easier here, I'm going to select those cells. And I'm just going to give it a name. I'll click up here and call this grades. That name has to be a single word, no spaces. So we have our named range now, equal VLOOKUP of this percentage score in the grades table. And then it wants to know, what column do we want? All right, well, we have column 1 is the score. We already have that. Column 2 is the grades. That's what we want. And there we go, converts that 85% to a B. We'll copy it down. Alright, so there you go. Over the course of the week, we've come up with several different formulas. The nice thing about this, though, is now if you actually update the score. So here we are in row 7. This person currently has an F. They turn in their assignment. They got a 35. Now they're up to a D. So all of the formulas are live. You can, you can enter your grades and see what the results are right here on the fly. Now, hey, the most important thing, remember when we got the data back on Monday, gradebookdata.csv, well, all of these cool formulas that we created cannot live in a CSV file. If I would save this as a CSV, all of those formulas are going to change the numbers. That would be very frustrating. Make sure to do file save as, and then choose one of the Excel file formats, whatever you usually use. Now, XLSX, XLSM, XLSB, or if you're in the old version of Excel, even XLS, just choose one of those. And make sure to save the data. Maybe even say, that this is period 3 or something like that, so we can differentiate it from the others. Well, there you go, a whole week's worth of the gradebook application. Lots of different formulas, including extracting the numbers from the square brackets up here, so that way we could figure out the points possible. That huge formula from yesterday, the sum if is blank with Control Shift Enter, and then VLOOKUP today to convert that to a letter grade. And hey, remember, if all of this is just a big hassle, you want to download the macro, it's absolutely free. Go to MrExcelLabs.com/gradebook and we'll let you use that macro that does all of the steps that we just did over the course of this week, but makes it just a simple keystroke Control Shift G. Well, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast, Mr. Excel.